Can you imagine if that thing made that little noise those little door stoppers make? No one would have ever beat this game. Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to another one of my super high, awesome quality Let's Plays. That's sarcasm. Quackshot for the Sega Genesis. I'm gonna change my settings here real quick. Sorry, I hope you don't mind. Let's go and get started with the story. I'll let you guys read it up. Alrighty, welcome to the overworld. Yes, as you can see here, we have three levels to choose from. We have Duckburg, Mexico, and Transylvania. Rest assured, I won't do that every time. That is atrocious. Let's go ahead and get started in Duckburg. See what this game is all about. So, I know what you're thinking. What? Donald Duck game? Seriously? This has to be complete garbage. Actually, it is a damn good platformer. One of my favorites, oddly enough. I really can't explain it. I don't play many Disney games, but when I do, it's Quackshot. Alright, so, as you can see, that was one of the health items you can get. Donald eats other birds for health. That's good. Which is a cooked chicken, I believe, is what it's officially called. I guess I should go over the bottom. You have your power, which is your life, temper, your lives, whatever you have, your weapon equipped. Whoa, I just totally moved my ass onto that chili pepper. And of course you have points, blah blah. As you see, my temper meter went up. You can find certain items, like chili peppers, that just piss you the hell off. And when you have a full temper meter, you become invincible and just beat the fuck out of anything that comes in your path. That was some popcorn ammo, which is basically a shotgun, only, you know, kid-friendly. Whoa, bees. Oh god, not the bees! This is falling apart very quickly. That's another health pickup that I totally miss. It only refills one tick, whereas God damn it. Chicken, I believe, is full, right? That is an asshole. I'm not sure what the point of that guy is, really. Is he part of Pete's gang? Is he just the trash can monster? I don't know. Anyways, whoop! When you see an enemy who has a, like, satchel on them, fuck you. You can shoot the character and get an item. If they don't have a satchel on them, they're not gonna drop anything for you. But, you know, probably in your best interest to stun them anyway. Oh, we gotta have something to climb the wall. Okay. So, when you get to a certain spot in the map, you put down a checkpoint, which you can then use to call in your plane. We'll go ahead and use that right now. Oh, the music in this game is phenomenal. So we can't scale that wall. We may as well check out another level. Let's go to Mexico, south of the border. We could probably pick up some really cheap tequila. You know, I've had that before, and it is insanely easy to drink. It's dangerously easy. All right, anyways, Jesus, what is my aim? It's a side scroller. You don't have to aim for the head, man. Alright, anyways, despite me doing just so terrible, we're at the beginning of the game, so I have time to warm up. I really didn't practice at all for this Let's Play. It's just like, you know what, I want to play this one. So I just kind of jumped in. I hope I remember everything accurately enough. Alright, watch out for the fucking cactus and the gosh darn vultures. I cuss too much. Vultures will drop the eyes, as you saw earlier. And, the sand lobsters, that, you know, there are lobsters in the desert, right? That is how that works. Alright. Got extra life, which is in the form of an Indiana Jones head. You're gonna see a lot of homages to Indiana Jones in this game. It's essentially a tribute, if you will, or, I don't know, necessarily a tribute, but a lot of references. Anyways, gonna move on here. You can also see, I haven't killed anything. Your plunger attack, which is your main gun, does upgrade, however, it will never actually kill an enemy. It only stuns them, which you'd think is bad, but the way the game plays, it really, it works. It's not bad at all. And if you really need to kill anything, you can use some of your popcorn gun, which we will show off here in a bit. I am just taking so much damage. Whoa, alright. And we have instant death pits. First occurrence of these in the game. We will definitely see more of them in the future. Without a doubt. With any good platformer, you need instant death pits. And whenever you step on those things, they don't really link to any explosives. I'm not sure how they damage you. Oh lord. Yep, full health. Sweet. But I guess the little ember that, you know, is on the fuse hurts you somehow. I got nothing on that one, guys. Just gonna stun those vultures, keep moving. Pretty easy stuff. Of course, this is really the first part you can truly die, you know, with relative ease. You do have to watch those pits, but if you've ever played a platformer before, not too bad. Okay, we need a special key to get into the Mexican ruins called the Hero Key. Thank you, sweet senorita. Okay, so, gonna go ahead and get the hell out of here again. Hope you guys have your green cards, because we are flying back to Duckburg, which seems a little weird. You'd think, you know, you'd want to check out Transylvania, which you can go to. You can explore any of these levels whenever you want, but you won't be able to progress. We need to grab an item here from this guy. Hey, dude, hero key. What? No, I'm not. You're trying to be a hero. You're just trying to get rich, man. That's not being a hero. You're trying to get laid, get his girlfriend some fabulous prizes. So we get the key, and we're wasting a lot of gas because, I don't know, we can just leave the plane. Why do we have children flying planes anyway? It's craziness. Anyways, I'm arguing about, you know, games with, like, talking animals. It's the realism. Fly back to Mexico here. And thanks. The game's just telling you you need to actually use an item to open doors, stuff like that. Go ahead and look at it. It's the hero key. Well, fair enough. Go ahead and use it. Yep. And we entered the first real difficult spot of the game, in my opinion. I say difficult, but it is most assuredly harder than anything we've encountered before. There's a lot of ways to die, and this is a long area with minimal health pickups. So, if you've noticed how I've been playing recently, I will most definitely die. Rest assured. Whoa, yep, see that? That was risky. Not worth the risk at all. There's really no time or anything, so I don't know why I went there. So, we can actually stun this guy and climb up onto him, which we're going to see here again, which we have to use to get up to the very top right here. Come on. Yep. And jump. What do we have ahead? What do we have? Oh, we have ancient Mexicans, apparently. I don't know. Are they part of Pete's gang too? It confuses me. Just roll with it, guys. Seriously, it's a Disney game. What do you expect? Though the plot does make more sense than Kingdom Hearts, but that really isn't saying much. It's Kingdom Hearts makes about as much sense as me getting laid ever. So we're gonna keep. Oh yeah, you can slide like Mega Man. Check that out. Pretty neat little move. In fact, you'll probably see me spamming it a lot when I'm in a section where I need to. That was really stupid, like, travel a prolonged distance, because it's a lot easier than running, and if I believe it's faster? Is it like the Ocarina of Time roll, or... Well, okay, I know that is faster, but for a while there, I wasn't too sure. Alright, so, get up here. Do some sliding right into enemies. Alright. Yep. We're gonna... Oh, come on. Come on. Yep. Alright, Donald. We got this, man. We got it. Get up here. More of the scoop, you bastard. Get you. This is such good commentary. I can't even describe how good it is. No, we're just gonna keep playing stupidly. Timing's a little tricky on this guy. Yeah, that was a good one. Get over here. And I believe we're nearing the end. We'll see a familiar face. Definitely not doing his voice, good lord. Alright, what are you doing here, man? Yeah, he's just looking around, blah blah blah. He found a note. So, oh hell yeah, it's our first upgrade. Shoot it at walls, it will help you reach high places. Oh, and we have some direction in the game. We need to go back to Duckburg, climb that wall that we couldn't climb before. Alright, so we take the red plunger and the note. Red plunger. It's already equipped. What is the note? One sun, two moon, three star. Alright, very important. Make sure you keep that in mind. Oh yeah, I guess I'll show this off. Check it out! Sticks to walls, jump off it. It is freaking sweet. I love the game mechanic here. You can really explore around and have fun with it. It is pretty cool. And we'll be seeing a lot. Maybe ask yourself, do you really have to backtrack all the way through the pyramid again? Yep, totally. So we have to walk all the way back out. That's what I was saying, like, health is pretty scarce in this level. You don't have enemies that you can really knock out for health. And I think there was only that one chicken, which we saw earlier. Which, heaven forbid, you need health from the last level, then you would have already used it. Anyways, you keep sliding. Not too bad. This part always screws me up. Not really, but... should have just went. Usually I get impatient and try and scale this left wall, but you can't, because you can't really grab ladders in midair, and of course you can't get up there by just wall jumping. Which is unfortunate, because you want to try out your new item. Is there like a... I can't help but wonder if there's a shorter way to the entrance. Alright, well, not a big deal. These guys don't have any satchels on them, so they're never going to drop anything for us. Yeah, in the purse! I could show up the popcorn and show you how you can kill guys, but we will eventually. Don't rush me, guys. You gotta take your time. I'm gentle like that. Alright, so, climb back here. Hit the fire because you got cocky now that your health is full. And almost back at the entrance, finally. This place, we mentioned before, can be harrowing if you don't take your time. You aren't too incredibly familiar with the game, which usually you aren't at this point. So, remember, we need to go back to Duckburg. So why don't we go and check that out right now? Yeah. Well, when else would we do it? I know you guys are just dying to see Transylvania, though. No, we're never doing that. Okay, maybe next time, but, you know. We'll go ahead and scale this wall here. Yes. I love it. More games should do that. Like, Altair wish he could fucking climb buildings as fast as Donald. Altair's got nothing on that guy. Oh man, I got hit by the megaphone. Alright, so, the megaphones shoot booms at us, sonic booms. So you gotta watch out for those. And, what do we got? Oh, full health. Game is feeling generous today. Let's hit the upper path and just leap of faith off. Instant death pit right there, so you're gonna wanna... Eat you mother. Popcorn. Good times. And seriously, are you not digging this music? It is so cool. I absolutely love it. I'm not usually a big fan of Genesis music. Like I mentioned in my last one, I would really like Comic Zone soundtrack, which I do. But yeah, usually I was much more into Super Nintendo at the time, and that kind of grew on me. But you cannot argue this music. It's fucking cool. You also can't argue that this section used to beat my prepubescent dick in when I was a child, because it is so difficult when you don't have good reflexes. Nowadays, it's really not a big deal. I can do this. I was going to be cocky and say with my eyes closed, but that would be damn near impossible for me. However, I can do it. Let's just say that. I'm going to take... Ooh, my flashing almost messed me up there. I'm going to take a lot of damage, and then I'm going to die, because, hubris kills me all the time. That's something you're gonna notice about me if you continue to watch my videos. I tend to get super cocky And I have a lot of stupid deaths. So, we're down to 2 lives. We've already lost 2. We have gained 1 in the desert, but... What was I saying earlier about I can do this almost blindfolded? Yeah, that was a good joke. Do you guys like when I make jokes like that? I sure do. And jump. Okay. Let's take the lower path. Why not? What do we have? Just some shit. Oh, actually... I was scratching my face. I'm so glad that I put my hand back on the controller. That's actually the path we take, because we have to backtrack, believe it or not. We have to go back through that. Okay, this is Gyro. Gives us one of his new inventions. Bubblegum ammo. Excellent. Sounds really stupid, but it's super helpful. So we're going to go ahead and go all the way back. Hopefully I won't die as many times this time. Actually, I know for a fact I won't, because the trek back is so much easier. In fact, it's impossible to die if you just set the controller down. You'll even go to the next area without having to touch anything. It's pretty nice, especially if this place stresses you out like it did there and you lose 2 lives. Alright. So, we do have to go back this way, though. Hopefully there won't be any more stupid deaths. I don't know why I tried to jump on there. Like I mentioned before, you can't grab on in midair. Yeah, you gotta grab it from the bottom. Grab it from the shaft! Alright, so... There's a little Mickey Mouse cameo in the background. And can I make that jump even? Alright. Let's see here. Alright, one more try. It's not the end of the world if I don't... Oh, I scrolled the plunger off. I guarantee I would have made that jump, though. Alright, kill the Koopa Troopa. Get over here. Dude, you're gonna have to come out of your shell eventually. Come on. You're killing me, Smalls. You are literally killing me right now because you damaged me. Alright. This game. This is gonna be a rough one. I can already predict it. Oh, full health. Hey, buddy. Alright. So, don't fall in the pit now. You're almost at the end. Yeah. Good hey, that's not the exit. I was like, alright, well, let's wrap it up. Alright. So we are done with the first episode. We're gonna go ahead and just stop at this checkpoint here. Actually, we'll stop at the world map, because I really dig this music. Yeah, you guys can hear it. Alright. Well, thanks for joining me. I hope you don't mind a Disney game. It is incredibly epic. Again, try not to judge it just on those that value. We'll see you next time. Thank you guys for joining me. Take care.